In this video, I will show you how to use Python Virtual Environments, Virtual Env, and Pip Env, which are very popular Python Virtual Environment softwares. So why virtual environment are needed? Suppose in your computer, there are many Python packages and you are working on a project, suppose a Django project. If you don't know what Django is a very popular Python web framework. So if you are working on a Django project, in which Django 2.1 is needed and in your computer Django 3.0 is installed, so what will you do? Then you have to install, uninstall packages, and that can be very time consuming. So virtual env keeps the requirements separate. After you activate virtual environment, in that environment no packages are installed. Then as your project grows, you can install specific versions of packages one by one, and that's very much helpful. Suppose you are going to deploy your Django website on a server, then why would you install all your system's packages on that server? You will also only install those packages which are required by your Django project. So first I will show you how virtual env is used. So I will use PowerShell here, in which you can use command line commands. So I am navigating to my desired directory by typing commands. I will show you another way to navigate and open PowerShell, which is very much easy. You can see in my Python project no folders are here. LS is used to list all the folders inside a directory. So another way is navigate to your folder using this way and type PowerShell. Now you can see in that directory itself PowerShell is opened. So that's very much easy. I didn't use any commands to arrive here. To install virtual env, you have to just type pip install virtual env. Since I have already installed virtual env, this has been shown here. But for you, if you didn't have virtual env in your system, it will be installed. Now I am listing all the files inside my project folders, and you can see there are no files. To activate virtual env inside this folder, you have to type virtual env and the name of your virtual env folder, in which all the files will be created to activate your virtual environment. You can see in the background that my virtual env folder is being created, and many more files are created inside this folder, which will be helpful to activate virtual environment. It takes some time. Now after virtual env folder is created, you can see all the files are created here. To activate virtual environment, just navigate inside that folder, then type scripts/activate. Now you can see there is a parenthesis, and inside this parenthesis virtual env folder's name is being shown. So this is a visual confirmation that virtual environment is now active, which is not in the case of pip env in Windows. Now I have printed the present working directory. Now to deactivate virtual environment, just type deactivate. You can see that the parenthesis is not shown now. This shows that we came out of virtual environment. To install pip env, just type pip install ppnv. Since I have already installed, to activate virtual environment via ppnv, just type ppnv shell. You can see that pip file is being created. This also takes some time, but unlike virtual env, in pip env there is no visual confirmation that virtual environment is activated or not. This occurs in Windows only, not in other operating systems. You can see there is no parenthesis now. This is obvious because I have already said, but actually virtual environment is active. How to know that? I am typing pip freeze. Pip freeze lists all the Python packages inside your environment. You can see that there are no Python packages since we have not installed one. To exit virtual environment by ppnv, just type exit. Now after exiting, whenever I have typed pip freeze, you can see all the packages inside my system. This is a visual confirmation that we have exited out of the virtual environment. So in the next video, I will show in more details how to use virtual env and pip env. So you can head over to the respective one.